Today I want to present you altars, depicting admired persons, displaying idols, but in another way, just another kind of altars. This is the altar of Castelos. It is named after the small village Castelos on the island of Crete, where it was created. On the outside, you see a holy scene transformed to a political motif. If I open it, you recognize an old tradition of painting. The colors stand for the paradise, left, our world in the middle, and right, finally, the hell. In bright daylight and close by, one usually recognizes only a colorful tangle of plant-like shapes. However, if looked at in dimmer light or from a distance, the represented person appears in the foreground. In this way, it can happen that suddenly Jim Morrison stands in front of us. His arms wide opened, he stands there. The former frontman of the Doors, who died of drugs. Like Christ on the cross. The perfect posing. Completely different is the story of this altar, the John Lennon Peace Altar. Here everything starts in the war, in chaos. Finally, the child is born, named John Lennon, and he changes with his thoughts the world. Too early he went away from us, and therefore the idea of peace will remain a dream for a while. Also in this painting, which consists of 5 parts, the details are important. The most important of them are the peace symbols. Now let's have a look on another altar. It is called the Death and the Maiden, and it is provided with a carving. Princess Diana in the arms of death. Gently she's looking at him, and his arms are embracing her. Her face is totally shaped by roses. But death is everywhere. He grins out of the cracks. And exactly this contrast between beauty and horror is the main sign of this triptych and makes it notable. Yes, there exists another altar, the Arnold Schwarzenegger altar, but it's under construction now. And this will be another story.